So good morning. I love you. Thank you for showing up here. I was so worried that, you know, kickoff day 2, 8 a.m. I was like, what? Who's going to show up at 8 a.m.?
When I speak, I know immediately if I'm connecting with an audience.
So I felt like I had to bribe people a little bit. I was a little worried about this 8 a.m. start time, which is why I titled the talk today, Challenge Your Marketing Assumptions and Get a Free Puppy, an Intervention.
Humor is a very important part of that. People absorb information way better when they're having fun, and marketers are just that, people.
I think in marketing, we have this notion that we want to try to get as many people into like the top of the funnel, so to speak, as possible. We want to get as many people, but maybe that's not the best approach. Maybe you'll spend a lot of time sort of nurturing relationships that really aren't going to be a great fit ultimately.
Most of us are terrified of standing out, to step off this well-traveled path, to try something new, but that's where the magic happens.
I do think that the biggest missed opportunity in marketing in general is playing it too safe.
We marketers need to get away from being order takers and instead own the narrative. And we need to own the customer relationships. I challenge every business to be bigger, bolder, and braver, to tell bigger stories with a bolder voice that creates braver marketing. Ask yourself, if you covered up your logo on your website, on your marketing materials, do you sound like everybody else? Or do you sound different than your competitors?
Here's how they describe themselves. Infusing life, style, and functionality into a drink insulator. Established in 2011, Fricker USA quickly grew to be the global leader of preventing moist handshakes and sweaty beverages. They're giving you an invitation to their party, a starter kit for a new lifestyle. The Fricker is the background music to a never-ending journey. Doesn't this sound different? It's a can koozie, it's a drink insulator. But it doesn't sound like that. It sounds like a movement, doesn't it?
Technology is great, but sometimes it can get in the way of true human connection. So we have a choice. Ask yourself about every bit of marketing that you create. So what? Why does your customer care? We have an opportunity to create marketing that has real value for our customers. But to get there, we have to know them first. We have to talk to them. We have to research them. We have to create not just surface level understanding, but actually next level empathy. I call this next level pathological empathy, really understanding the world from their point of view.
And the class was how to brew an amazing cup of coffee. And I was like, that's ridiculous. Like, I've been drinking coffee my whole adult life almost. Like, why do I need to take an hour-long class to find out I'm doing it wrong? So I took it. I like the idea of training as marketing, right? Of actually thinking about how can we elevate our customers? Because in the end, you want them to feel not just smarter, you want them to feel like they're part of something.
I became a speaker because my words come alive. They become more tangible. They have a pulse. I love looking out into an audience and knowing that my message is resonating with everybody who is there. My craft as a speaker, as a marketer, as a business owner is grounded in my first love of writing, which is an essential skill for creating engaging content, which is the foundation for great marketing. So great writing ultimately respects the audience. It helps us think of things from their point of view. And when we are brave enough to take a stand, to put ourselves out there, people notice.
I do think that tone of voice is your gutsiest, bravest asset. But essentially what it means is it's not about grammar, right? It's actually about something different. It's about what you're like to deal with, not just, you know, what you do and who you are, but what you're actually like to deal with.
I inspire business leaders to rethink their marketing, to create marketing that doesn't feel like marketing. And I empower marketers to become the best versions of themselves. Marketing is part art, and part science. Marketing is art plus intent.
Could this be the beginning of love forever?